Can I ask you two questions? At what temperature does water boil? Will water always boil at this temperature? To answer these questions, you first have to know some concepts. Watch. A pan of water is placed on a stove, and heat from the stove is transferred to the water at some rate. When the water boils, it changes to steam. Vapor bubbles form within the liquid, expand, rise to surface, burst, and release vapor. The bubbles are able to form by overcoming the atmospheric pressure exerted by the weight of the air above the water. If we go up in mountains, the air becomes less dense, so the atmospheric pressure is reduced because the air weighs less. Now we know that there is a pressure pressing on the liquid from above. Okay, but forming vapor bubbles requires a pressure exerted by the vapor counteracting the atmospheric pressure. This is what keeps bubbles from collapsing. The pressure is called vapor pressure, or saturated vapor pressure. Again, the higher the altitude, the lesser the atmospheric pressure. Therefore, less vapor pressure is necessary to form bubbles. As long as the liquid boils, when its vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure. But what if a liquid has a vapor pressure lesser than the atmospheric pressure? How is the vapor pressure increased in order to boil the liquid? The vapor pressure can be increased by raising the temperature of the liquid, and thus, boiling is induced when the liquid reaches its boiling point. As the temperature is increased, the molecules move more, and more of them can break free from their neighbors to enter the gas phase, increasing the vapor pressure. When the temperature increases, the molecules have more energy to change state, increasing the vapor pressure. As the bubbles overcome the atmospheric pressure, they rise to the surface. Once the water reaches the boiling point, the temperature remains constant until all of it has turned into steam. The added heat energy breaks bonds, rather than increasing temperature and the average kinetic energy. So the heat energy is used to convert the liquid to a gas. In short, we can cause a liquid to boil in two ways: by increasing the temperature of the liquid, or by decreasing the pressure exerted on the liquid. Since cooking time depends on the temperature, it takes longer to cook foods in boiling water at high altitudes, because the water boils at a temperature lower than 100 degrees Celsius, and the temperature does not rise during boiling. If the pressure is increased, as in a pressure cooker, the boiling point is higher than 100 degrees Celsius, cooking the food faster. The boiling temperature is also raised to above 100 degrees Celsius if there are any impurities, such as salt or another ingredient. Well, I hope I was able to answer your questions. If you like this content and want to support the channel in producing more, you can subscribe.
Thanks for watching and bye.